principle of that conversation.
You go over there with Jeff Greger.
Mr. President, Mr. Holmes, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to welcome you all warmly to today's event. We are living in a highly controversial time. On one side, there is a technology revolution going on in the world, and the industrial breakthroughs that have been unthinkable so far. On the other side, in our case and in many CE countries and beyond, there are fossilized and captured institutions as part of the captured state problem. In other words, there is a systemic problem which requires a systemic solution through deep structural and institutional reforms, not just by changing the persons who perform the roles. In this context, we proposed an action agenda to attract constructive capital in Bulgaria. This action program, action agenda, is part of Bulgaria's efforts in the context of the presidency of the three C's initiatives. For this purpose, I wish to especially acknowledge President Roman Radev and thank for his contribution. And finally, we are always glad when we have our strategic partners next to us, when we try to address key problems for our country and our development. That is why it is especially, I'm very pleased to offer the floor to Mr. Kim Holmes, Vice Chairman of the Board of the Center for International Private Enterprise. Believe it or not, we've been working with this organization for 30 years. He has a long career in the Heritage Foundation. Until a few months ago, he was the Executive Vice President, and he also served as Assistant Secretary of State. The floor is yours, Mr. Holmes.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm very pleased and honored to be with you today. Very pleased that the weather seems to be sort of cooperating. But it's really an honor to be here. I have a long history with the Center for International Private Enterprise, having served on the board twice. I know of no other American organization that does more to link the critical importance of private enterprise and democracy than this organization, CIPE. We are not alone in these efforts in the United States. We are very proud of our associations with the U.S. Chamber of Commerce and the National Endowment for Democracy, with whom we work every day in close proximity and cooperation. Speaking on behalf of the board, we very much appreciate CIPE's long-standing work with the Center for the Study of Democracy. CIPE is honored to call CSD a long-standing partner, and we are pleased to work with its leadership to support the work of strengthening the environment of constructive capital in Bulgaria and the region. I would especially like to thank CSD's chairman, Ogden Chentov, for partnering with us. CIPE has been CSD's longest U.S. partner in ushering Bulgaria on the road to a market-based democracy. We started back in 1990 with private sector development was, at the very least, very weak. We then moved on to developing an investment framework in Bulgaria and to establishing the first new business associations and business support organizations. In the late 1990s, In the early 2000s, CIPE helped CSD develop a comprehensive anti-corruption agenda in Bulgaria. We also established a regional good governance civil society and private sector network in Southeast Europe, which is still active to this day. Specifically, we helped establish the Soviet Economic Council as a flagship initiative on constructive capital. Our aim was to strengthen the capacity of private sector actors, particularly SMEs and regional chambers, to lead on initiatives to strengthen the investment environment for constructive capital. This is crucially important. Creating an environment for constructive capital not only opens the pathways to enhance prosperity for everyone, it also supports a rule of law environment and adherence to democratic norms. I'm happy that we can continue the cooperation by setting up a constructive capital agenda with the 3 C's initiatives. When I was executive vice president at the Heritage Foundation, I worked with our staff on the 3 C's initiative, and I'm very pleased and happy indeed to continue that work with CIPE and CSD. It will help Bulgaria and the 3 C's region leverage public EU recovery and resilience funding to attract more private investors from the United States and Europe. This is important because the U.S. and the European Union abide by the highest ethics and business standards. The initiative will reinforce the Bulgarian government and President Radev's efforts to uphold the rule of law and establish a strong good governance rule in Bulgaria. In this respect, I would like to thank the Enterprise Europe Network's Bulgarian branch at the CSD sister organization, the Applied Research and Communications Fund, which is Europe's largest business support organization. I would like to thank as well the Bulgarian businesses for sharing their input on the agenda over the past 6 months. Let me conclude by thanking President Radev for his vision and for his initiative in including our work on constructive capitals in the 3 C's initiative agenda. We believe this initiative has great potential in upgrading the region's technological base, digitalizing its economies, and supporting energy transition. President Radev and his team have demonstrated their commitment to upholding higher governance standards not only in Bulgaria but in Europe. And we at CIPE are more than happy to support these efforts through private sector engagement. We are aware, Mr. President, that it's been a difficult time, that you've taken responsibility to carry through Bulgaria through these difficult times. And it's not only the pandemic, but it's also other issues of the caretaker government that you've had to deal with. And in spite of all of that, you have stayed true to this mission. We recognize that, and we very much appreciate it. We wish you all the best and your success in these efforts, and we look forward to taking the Constructive Capital Initiative to the next level of implementation. So thank you, Mr. President, and all of you for what you've done, and thank you for welcoming us to Bulgaria. Thank you.
Of course, there is hardly more relevant social technology for the implementation of any serious reform agenda for public-private partnership. Whenever we want structural changes, we have to find a form for cooperation between private organizations, businesses, and private organization. We should also look for support from international partners to ensure that we have success with the reforms we are aiming to make. This being said, I think public institutions in Bulgaria have an extremely crucial role, including President Radev. It is my huge pleasure to open the floor to President Radev, President of the Republic of Bulgaria. Mr. Shentov, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it is my huge pleasure to welcome you at the present forum. It takes place under the auspices of the Three Seas Initiative, and Bulgaria was the host of the sixth summit. And we are happy that our Latvian friends have taken the baton and will continue the initiative under their leadership next year. I wish to say something important which happens in the past year and in this year for the development of this initiative. It is directly related to the development of constructive capital in Bulgaria. By the way, the term constructive capital in Bulgaria is not well proliferated, is not disseminated, but it comes with huge opportunities. It is the key for us to have an innovative and competitive economy. And it provides yet another opportunities among the many other opportunities which an open market economy should have to ensure progress. But back to the Three Seas initiatives, as you know, the key priorities of this initiative, and especially the three single initiatives until this year, were energy, transport, and digital connectivity. What I proposed at the summit in Estonia in the end of 2020 was to add another important priority: educational, scientific, and innovative connectivity. In the beginning, I admit, this priority was regarded a bit bizarre. There was certain reserves, but very often, very soon, based on our detailed explanations, our partners from these 12 countries, members, and our strategic partners, the US, Germany, and the European Commission, became convinced that actually this is the key to the future of this initiative. Why? Because if we look only at hardware, at infrastructure, at pipes, asphalt, cables, indeed in 20 or 30 years we will install them. But what comes next? So that we have opened the door to the future which we are to build today. And the future is young people. The future is scientific and research institutions and laboratories and innovative enterprises. They should come together and connect their potential so that we make a strong commitment to the future. And I'm very happy to have, I see that Mr. Danowski is here. He was tasked to communicate with the partner organizations similar to our innovation agency and work towards the conclusion of a memorandum during the sixth meeting in Sofia. This memorandum opened our collaboration in this area, and I'm happy that we opened the door. We were successful. There is much work to do, but the groundwork is already done, because without technological development, without innovation, we would not have the future which we deserve. And I keep repeating that no matter what funds come to Bulgaria, any social and economic coherence fund will be useless until we innovate science and innovation. That is why I believe it is crucial to work for the development of their infrastructure. As concerns constructive capital and its link with the 3C, actually something new happened. The financial fund of the initiative, together with the under financial group in London, made so that to provide yet another opportunity for all progressive innovatives, SMEs, gain access to funding, but also to present themselves in the best light possible on the basis of results and ideas. And this program is already up and running. And exactly this is the stronger link between public and private partnership, because the fund goes to the states, but it ends up in the private sector. The private sector, which has demonstrated its potential, and together with the European funds, together with the development and sustainability mechanism, we provide yet another opportunity, and this opens widely the door for the successes of our economy. I wish to welcome all of you. I'm happy that I'm part of the finalists for an innovative undertaking for 2020, and I can promise that these initiatives are addressed to you. Thank you, Mr. Holmes, for your presence in Bulgaria, for your interest in Bulgaria. This is presence and commitment which is absolutely justified. The greatest potential, the greatest promise for the future of Bulgaria are our young people and their achievements. Probably Mr. Shentov will agree, because he is one of the sponsors of these programs. But our young people in secondary schools always win the top five prizes at all global Olympiads in maths, physics, linguistics, programming, biology. This is indeed a huge potential. Small Bulgaria, of population 7 million, sits on the stage together with giants such as the US, Russia, and China. That means that investments in Bulgaria are bound to succeed. I'm great that you are here, that you encourage and give hope to our talents, to our SMEs, which have demonstrated that in this environment they can develop a successful business. They have incredible ideas, and actually these are the endeavors and these are the changes which we have been doing in the past months with the caretaker government, namely to provide, most importantly, a predictable environment for Bulgarian business and ensure that the state does not interfere with their development but supports their development.
Thank you, Mr. President. I'm giving the floor to Mr. Ruslan Stefan, who will present the program for constructive capital in Bulgaria and program director of the Center for Study of Democracy. Thank you. Mr. President, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I think some of you can already have the document we have prepared, especially the program for constructive capital in Bulgaria. I hope this is only the first within the initiative 3Cs. In order to be brief and to have the opportunity to meet and to foster the private-public partnership, I will try to present the program very briefly. It is based on the research of all documents of the organizations International and Bulgaria. Also including the Center for Study of Democracy within the six regions in Bulgaria. We visited the business, the local associations, the business association, to see how the local environment influences the opportunities for constructive capital and what we can work in this direction. I'm not going to talk about the challenges. You can see them in the document itself. I would like only to say that we need to to guarantee the rule of law. I think this was one of the main wishes of the local business. Just briefly, what are the two ideas? You know, Bulgaria is comparatively poor of capital country. If we look at the investment of the GDP, they are only 20% of the GDP. If we look at other countries, which from comparatively poor countries moved into rich countries, we speak about 25-30%. And from on this side, for Bulgaria, it is going to be very important to attract constructive capital from the private sector. But apart from the volume of the capital which we need to attract, it's to create new enterprises. We need really to have the quality of this capital to look for business that invests new eco standards, new employer standards, and have high standards of ethic standards. And the most this is the most developed technological society of the United States, and not business that is looking for rents that will influence the policy. So this is the idea of the constructive capital, not just opposing to what we say corrosive capital. It is true that what is now what Bulgaria is now expecting is maybe the biggest public investment policy with the funds that we will have from the EU. But what is important is what part of this capital will, and what more private funds will we will be able to add. Talking about renewable energy resources, half of them are coming really from partners from the United States and the EU and the UK. At the moment, we still include UK and the EU. But what happens is that this investment go not always in countries like Bulgaria, initiatives like 3Cs. If we look at the capitals that is engaged in EU and especially in Bulgaria, for Bulgaria, when we look, it's 10 times lower than the other countries in the EU. For example, and I'm finishing with this, what Daimler did this month, it announced 70 billion euro as investment by 2025. The answer that Bulgaria needs to think about is what part of this investment will be attracted from the private sector so that we have new chains for adding value. Also what President Radev mentioned, what more people, what jobs will create, what other people we will attract to Bulgaria. We are really thankful for our partners from the Center for International Private Enterprise who've been with us, and hope this will give another stimulus for the development. Of course, you can see the program on our website. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Ruslan Stefanov. I have the pleasure to introduce Mr. Martin Danovsky, Chairman of the State Agency for Research and Innovation. Mr. President, Your Excellencies, Mr. Shentov, Mr. Holmes, I represent the Bulgarian Agency for Research and Innovation, and in this capacity, let me express my deep gratitude for the opportunity to address you. At the same time, I am hugely satisfied with the fact that in the report of the Center for the study of democracy, besides the problems, we see possible solutions at times which are very important for Bulgaria. Our Bulgarian country is right at a crossroads, and the way in which choose to implement economic transformation will define the road we will go down. In some internally conscientiously recognized way, we recognize that must be based on a new and higher added value of our business. We realize that we should benefit from entrepreneurship, research and innovation to ensure that our growth is stronger and more intensive. What is special about this moment? The special about this moment is that experience both need and change key policies in the area of education and innovation. And on the other side, there we have huge financial resources available for Bulgaria, which we should progress and program and use smartly. These are more than 5.5 billion left in the next 5 to 7 years in measures and instruments for research and development from sources, including the European Union in the form of the European Structural and Innovation Funds and Investment Funds, the National Development, the Fair Transition Fund, etc. I think that the authors of the report have been very successful in highlighting the topic of how Bulgaria should attract constructive capital, which has been on the tip of our tongues in the past years, but we phrased it in another way, but we also did the various activities trying to attract such capital in Bulgaria. Yes, unfortunately, the absence of this condition has been a barrier to the acceleration of growth. Bulgaria has placed an ambitious goal, but it is fully achievable. The task is to double in the next 5 years the costs, the expenses of research institutions and businesses in the R&D. They should reach more than 1.6 of GDP. Yes, this is an average European target. This will not rank us among the frontliners, but for Bulgaria, that would be a great accelerator towards achieving the resources, the results. Only public capital would not be sufficient, and in some cases it would distort the market. For sure, we need to create an environment which is attractive to private capital and the PPP model where everyone is comfortable and produces results. In a couple of words, we have much homework to do, and as a result of this homework, we must create a Bulgarian microclimate. Why Bulgarian? Because the recipe for creating an environment is individual to each country. They are fundamentally different. We should find our recipe. And from this perspective, I am convinced that this requires concerted effort in the public area. As regards the public area, which I represent, to ensure that this agenda, well structured and described in the report, becomes a reality under the rule of law through combining smart policies with efficient implementation mechanism and unlocking the regional potential. I believe that Bulgaria is a huge debtor to its region. regions through the process of decentralization, but not in the most global context. Instead, we must provide more opportunities and not just give the fish, but to give them the fishing rod, the bite, to give them the skills to do the fishing. An important element of this national effort, I believe, is the Agency for Research and Innovation. Our agency is part of a new institutional framework. It implements a policy which is new for Bulgaria, which is an important element of the reform which we have started and which will help the constructive capital penetrate the country in a more organic manner. This reform affects the technology transfer, affects the research universities that we intend to develop, and the new model of collaboration between all players. How the agency plans to facilitate the establishment of a microclimate for constructive capital. Firstly, by shortening the way between policies and instrument. Now the speed of implementation of certain instruments is more important than the size, focus, and scope of an instrument. But second, by improving the dialogue and by results-focused research and innovation, but not in isolation, but in close collaboration with the financial and business world. And last but not least, by connecting the Bulgarian ecosystem with good practices of external partners from the region, from the EU, and of course with our partners from the US. This is where our efforts in the past months have been focused. We tried to work a working network for innovation and research in the 3Cs initiative. Our aim was to establish joint projects to attract investors in the region. And after the first steps, we had a meeting with eight of the countries. In October, we plan a meeting with all members of the 3Cs initiatives, where we will continue to develop and will try to put this air higher on the agenda, and most importantly, on the agenda of the investment fund and its new tools. With this brief presentation, I try to outline the challenges and the actions that we are to do, because I believe that we can achieve successful results together. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Danovsky. Now I would like to invite Mrs. Svetlana Bujanova, chairperson of the Bulgarian AgroHub. Dear Mr. President, Mr. Holmes, Mr. Shentov, thank you very much for the invitation. Agriculture is my passion, and I'm really happy that I can talk about agriculture and its development in Bulgaria on such a forum. Maybe not all of you know, but the agriculture in Bulgaria is very important, historically important, although nowadays it takes only 3% from the GDP of the country. In Bulgaria, 81% of our regions are really agricultural regions. We have all the environment, we have the soils, we have the water, but unfortunately we lack the human resources, for example. We lack also the innovations. The Bulgarian agriculture, apart from the natural environment, we work in the only policy of Brussels, that is the common policy. We have a serious financial resource for working. And the Bulgarian produce agriculture producers will receive 5 million euros, but also they can make there is 2 billion euros. So there is a good financial resource. And also within next generation program, we will receive also capital. There is a green transformation policy, which will again receive funds from there. As a sector, what issues we have, and we can think about attracting constructive capital. There are several key moments. So one is infrastructure, others are different measures that we need to implement, but also political changes that need to be done. On the first place is the irrigation, because even if we talk about digitalization, by the way, the information is really very punctual. This is that is the good direction. In order to implement precision farming, for example, where we will need funds as well, in order to implement all these measures, we need to have the main irrigation system in Bulgaria. Another issue which politicians and expert need to talk about the conversation is what we say land. The land at the moment is on very small pieces, and it's not it's on the owners. And another part is the capital. Digitalization will be really important, but it's the lack of the outflow of the from the agriculture of human resources. And of course, as it is mentioned in the on this information, and it's going along the whole chain. As chairman of the hub, I was also chairman of the 80 food hub in Bulgaria, so I have information along the whole food chain in Bulgaria, what opportunities we have to attract constructive capital. But this is mainly about the digitalization in the food industry, in the agriculture, also the circular economy issues. So here we really need to have support in order to have the innovative solutions. Another question that could be additionally developed, and it is mainly in the farm-to-farm strategy. This is the topic about the spoil of food, especially on the level of production, but also in the domestic and the households. Of course, we will need knowledge, but also financing, also funds for greener agriculture. And here we can include innovations for lowering the use of pesticides and chemicals, lowering the usage of fertilizers, and especially in Bulgaria, organic food and all these topics which have their potential, but they need to be encouraged with funding of the entrepreneurship in agriculture. There are startups in the food industry, but they are not so much connected with innovations, and we have all the prerequisites to for this to happen. So I will be really grateful after the official part if we can exchange with you some ideas for opportunities that could be supported by the constructive capital. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Mrs. Bojanova, and also for your contribution to developing the program for promoting constructive capital. Now, Mr. Boyko Takov, Executive Director of the Bulgarian SME Promotion Agency. Mr. President, Your Excellencies, Mr. Holmes, Mr. Shentov, first of all, thank you for the invitation. It is my huge honor to be among you. Having read the report, I wish to congratulate you for the report and for the efforts that you have been making for 30 years in this area. I am convinced that the results are visible, and my personal congratulations as an executive director of the SME agency. And to avoid repeating the previous speakers, I wish to have a look from a different perspective. I do not wish to enter the entrepreneurship topic because Dobry will speak to me. What we note in the SME agency as we work across all sectors, and when speaking about constructive and corrosive capital, of course, it's based on origin. When the origin is corrosive, probably, when the origin is corrosive, the results will be corroded. This capital, which comes from the EU programs, from various areas, per se, it's capital. It can't be constructive or corrosive. Constructive or corrosive depends on the state and on business and on the society as a whole. On one side, I have no doubt that the vast majority of society and business and the country, everyone wants a rule of law, transparency, clear rules. This is the way to attract constructive investments in our country, that is, private investments. On the other side, business has also its role in utilizing this capital. SMEs, not only in Bulgaria, but in the EU, account for 90% of the whole economy. They are the most natural user of many of these resources. In Bulgaria, we note something which we are trying hard to address. It's not only the measures. Of course, measures should be well structured. This is the task of the state to program the financial mechanism and then to control it, to control how the expenses are being made. But we encounter some lack of understanding or neglect for certain topics, including digitalization, cybersecurity, intellectual property, circular economy, and many others. This lack of understanding results then when some funds go to companies who don't realize that they do need these resources, and without it, they will be incompetitive. This is associated with a huge risk that this capital does not perform as expected. So many of our efforts are focused on the soft measures, not only training and skilling and reskilling. And indeed, we try to organize events and initiatives to demonstrate business that this is the right way, that without innovating, there will be no space for them on the international arena. And we are a small economy, and we can't do without the global markets. I wish that more of us consider this topic, because I am sincerely convinced that when the firms are convinced that they do need these funds, that they should engage in the circular economy. Traditionally, we wait for things to become mandatory. They will become one day by some mechanism, but then it will be too late. So preventively, companies should understand how to constructively use this resource. This requires a lot of focus on the part of the state, but businesses should also be proactive how to use and make this capital constructive. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Takov. I would like to give the floor to Mr. Dobromir Ivanov, chairman of the Bulgarian Startup Association. Dear Mr. President, Your Excellency, Mr. Holmes, Mr. Shentov, thank you for the opportunity to be together with you. I am representing BESCO, which is a young organization. We have 500 organizations, but it's high technology companies are included in our association. For these 3 or 4 years, one of the most interesting thing which I see is how companies, which only 4 years ago were only 3 or 4 people in one garage, now they have 300, 400 people, employees. It is really a question of a very short period of time to see our companies that will turn into the biggest employers in Bulgaria. Looking at the story and the history, I'm thinking about Bulgaria and how the growth of the economy it's really going on with one different speed now already. And this is a question not only about the reforms that needs to be done, but also it is about priorities, which are lacking and we need to have in the country, and what we are looking in, what we see, what we hear from our politicians is how there is enough money in Bulgaria, and if we stop the outflow, there will be enough money for everyone. I don't quite agree with this, because if we look at the GDP in Bulgaria, what we generate, it is like 4, 5, or 10 times less than these of countries that is the similar population. So we need to have higher speed, because in the next 3 or 4 years we'll continue to be lagging behind countries like the Czech Republic. So I really believe that the growth of the economy in Bulgaria is closely linked with companies like this, and not so much about the tenders and the public funds. These countries that are providing products which are on world level, global level. What we so it's in this information, it's really that these companies need talents, need employees, they need good environment that is even improving. We need to continue with the changes in the law, the laws of the loans. So when they when bankrupt, what will happen with these companies? All these topics in the education and the technologies, as the president mentioned, are valid. Also the blue cards, and we can be a open place for all, for example, programmers from other countries, developers from other countries. We need to have the angels invest, the capital funds, and all this will allow funds to go in the economy. Also the pension funds, which I don't think they have good results. It's not to invent the wheel. We just need to create environment that is competitive of the other European countries, and it is very important that this will happen quickly. For example, the reforms in the education sector, they need to get faster and to happen sooner. So I would like also to ask all of you not to talk only about the issues and how to resolve them, but also how we can be leaders, where we can be the first, which are these niches and industries where we can create the environment and so that people from the European countries and everywhere in the world to want to come to Bulgaria. So I think this, I thank you again for the invitation to be here today.
Thank you, Mr. Ivanov, and as well as for your active support for the development of the action agenda. As you know, today's forum is part of Bulgaria's presidency of the three C's. I wish to invite the ambassador of Latvia in Bulgaria, Mr. Edgar Bongers. Now, Latvia is the host of the initiative.
Dear Mr. President, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, my name is Edgar Bondars. I'm appointed recently as ambassador for 3C's initiative in my capital, Latvia. I will try to do my best. First of all, I would like to thank Bulgaria for excellent summit, which was held this summer. And I think it really high standards were established for in many fields. And we will also try to do our best in Riga. So Latvia will host next summit of 3C's initiative and business forum. It will take place in Riga in June 2022. We will continue to focus on importance of smartly developed energy, transport, and digital pillars that reinforce a secure and inclusive connectivity of the region's infrastructure and provides solutions that will ensure competitiveness of whole EU and strengthen transatlantic links. We underline the importance of strengthening EU cohesion, significance of close cooperation and financial involvement of the US in 3C's initiative investment fund and deeper cooperation with like-minded countries. Development of projects in the region that promote economic growth and sustainability. The importance of attracting investments for the development and inclusive connectivity. Success of enhanced 3C's connectivity lies in continued cooperation with strategic partners, the United States, Germany, and the European Commission, like-minded countries, as well as international financial institutions and the private sector. We appreciate the rising interest in the initiative from the UK, France, Japan, South Korea, Australia, and other countries outside of the region. It is crucial to raise awareness of the initiative and its goals. We emphasize the importance of also parliamentary and civil society dimension that will give substantial benefit and more visibility to the 3Cs initiative and the main goals of it. But besides those big targets, there of course will remain smaller targets and tasks which need to be fulfilled and can be fulfilled within 3C's initiative. It is a promoting of education, innovation, support for small and medium-sized businesses, agriculture, and a lot of other things. I'm strongly convinced that 3C's initiative format can provide support for those initiatives as well. So I think we can wish very good luck for the idea of 3C's initiative, strength of it, and we will move forward. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ambassador Bonders. Now we wish to invite the finalists in the national competition for innovative companies 22. These are excellent. They have the prize Excellence Innovation. It is organized by the Applied Research and Communication Foundation under the auspices of the Bulgarian president. Please come forth for a family photo, and everyone else is invited to a glass of wine.